Hello everyone and welcome to this channel. So guys, if you are aware of anything that is happening in the business world, yes, you can guess already, this video is about the business world and, you know, deal signing, contracts binding, and, you know, everything that involves shareholding. So two business moguls entered some sort of shareholding competition back in early 2023, when Femi Otedola, Nigerian billionaire, bought a certain percent of Transcorp that is that had at that time Tony Elumelu as the largest shareholder. You know, he bought about 5.5%, and a lot of persons were asking questions like, okay, why is Efote, as it's fondly called, why is it diversifying into Transcorp? Is there a buying opportunity and all of those things? And honestly, under 2 months, the shares of Transcorp Limited actually did increase. It doubled because a lot of investors and businessmen and women delved into that company. They were buying shares and all of those things. And when that happened, Tony Elumelu, via his special purpose vehicle, Hairs Holding. Yeah, Tony Elumelu, you know that he also owns Hairs Holding. He upped his stake, that is in Transcorp, by taking his ownership of the conglomerate to about 25.5%. And as at then, Otedola was at about 6%, right? So it was shocking when a few days later, Femi Otedola decided that he wanted to sell, and he sold to Tony Elumelu also. So it's like, okay, what's going on in the business world and what is going on between these two persons? It caused a lot of, you know, sentiments in the business world, people asking questions. Femi Otedola has now come out let us know why he actually decided to sell his share. And it seemed like, against everything that Elumelu and Otedola might be showing on social media and in public, their bromance, you know, having us believe that they're actually friends, it seems like there's maybe bad blood somewhere. And apparently all of this deal signing and brokering, none of them did it by themselves. Like, neither of them, they did it by proxy, which is very common with businessmen and billionaires. Of course, in the business world, they do their negotiation and transactions by proxy. But apparently, Mr. Otedola and Mr. Elumelu's Transcorp affair dates back to about 16 years ago, when Femi Otedola was the chairman of the company and Elumelu was still the MD CEO of Standard Trust Bank. Actually, guys, if you don't know the history of these two powerful men and how they got to become, you know, as big as they are now in the world, you might want to look into that. Their story is quite interesting. Okay, so after both of them had shared, you know, sentiments and said that, oh, they've agreed to work together, Otedola sold his share that he bought about 5.52% stake back in March. Then he bought more, then less than a month later he sold it, and Tony Elumelu is still, you know, retaining his position as the largest shareholder of the conglomerate. Now, this is what Mr. Otedola had to say, and I'm going to be quoting it for you. So from here onward, everything you will hear me say is Mr. Otedola's statement. And it goes thus. In 2005, while Tony was the managing director of the Standard Trust Bank, he approached me to get funds to acquire UBA. I enthusiastically gave him $20 million, which was ₦2 billion at that time, to buy the necessary shares in UBA for the acquisition. After a short period of time, the share price moved up and I decided it was a good moment to sell and get out of the bank. However, Tony appealed to me to hold on to the shares as he was convinced that there were future prospects, so I kept the shares. I became chairman of Transcorp Hotel in 2007 with a shareholding of 5%, and unknowingly, Tony gradually started buying shares quietly. By the following year, in 2008, I went bankrupt in Nigeria. Tony proceeded to take my shares in UBA to service the interest on my loans, and he also took over my shares in Africa Finance Corporation, where I was the largest shareholder. Shortly after, Albert Okumagba informed me that an American firm wanted to acquire my shares in Transco, which I then agreed to sell. However, this supposed American firm turned out to be Tony Elumelu. The revelation of this prompted me to resign as chairman of the hotel. Years later, in 2012, Tony said he wanted to see me. So we met in my office, where I had previously had a meeting with foreign investors who had not yet departed the premises. Curious to know, he asked what sort of meeting I had had, and I disclosed that I wanted to get into the power business, specifically Ugelu Power Plant. Tony quietly went ahead to bid for Ugeli, and he outbid me by offering to buy the plant for $300 million. And as some would say, the rest is history. Fast forward to the present. I offered to buy Transco PLC for $250 billion, Naira, but unfortunately my offer was rejected. My goal was to maximize the company's potential as a Nigerian conglomerate with a market cap of at least 2 trillion naira instead of the current 40 billion naira, but it seems some shareholders have a different vision. As a businessman, I believe in healthy competition and market dynamics. Two captains cannot man a ship, and I respect the majority shareholders' decision to buy me out. This is the nature of the game. But let me be clear. My offer was made with the best intentions for Transco PLC and its shareholders. I saw an opportunity to unlock the company's full potential and create value for everyone involved. It's important for investors to understand that free entry and free exit are crucial to a healthy market. The scramble for shares after my acquisition is a statement to the value that Transco PLC can offer, and I hope the company continues to thrive under new leadership. My message to Transco PLC and its shareholders is this: I remain committed to the growth and success of Nigerian businesses, and I will always be looking for ways to create value for stakeholders. Stakeholders are unfortunately always shortchanged by getting stipends, while the owners and managers of the business live a jet-set lifestyle, which is detrimental to the stakeholders. Thank you for the opportunity to engage in this exciting chapter of Transco's history. Femi Otedola. Now, if you've listened or if you've watched anything I just mentioned, you understand that there is beef. And list in all the statements of, this statement of Femi Otedola is the, the subtle insinuation that allegedly Tony Elumelu kind of beefed him and just continued going for what he was interested in and acquiring it, like you saw with the statement he mentioned about the Ugeli plant and how Tony Elumelu was secretly buying his own shares, even though Tony approached him first for some loan, etc. And Femi told they had like some kind of working relationship, only to be stabbed by Tony Elumelu in the back. All of these are what you can say that Femi Otedola did insinuate. And of course, we are hoping that, according to reports, they are saying that Tony Elumelu, the chairman of his holding, might actually have to come and say something about the statement that Femi Otedola has said. It seems like both of them are saying, or it seems like Femi Otedola is saying, it's time for me to air out our dirty laundry. Let's just talk about this publicly. It's been 16 years brewing, guy. What the heck is wrong with you? Okay, so let's see what's going to happen. If you don't understand everything I've read, that's just a summary. He accused Elumelu of secretly buying shares in Transco Holding and Transco Hotel and outbidding him to acquire Ugeli Power Plant after he told Elumelu that he wanted to acquire the plant, and also that Tony Elumelu took his shares in UBA and Africa Finance Corporation to service the interest on his, that is, Femi Otedola's loan when he went bankrupt in Nigeria. Did you even know that Otedola had to declare bankruptcy in Nigeria at some point? See why I said you need to find this guy's stories and read about it. It's not just, you know, for aspire to pass by, but just to be familiar with how this man got to where they are today. So that when we move forward to this gist, you are going to, you know, very well understand everything going on. Okay, yeah, That's it. Despite all the rumors that these guys have been sharing, seem like there is bad blood somewhere. All of these are allegations though, and understand that I don't have any affiliation or ties to Transcorp Holdings, Transcorp Hotel, to Hells Holdings, to the UBA Group, to Ford Oil, or whatever businesses that these guys are involved in. I'm just reporting what's going on social media. Thank you for understanding. Now, if you find this interesting or you loved it anyway, please give it a thumbs up to show that you do, that you like it. Share with family and friends, everybody around you. I'm going to see you in the next video. Until then, take care of yourselves and bye, guys.